Yeah, so this was basically the classification of the semi-simple V-algebras. And now I want to start to talk about representation theory. So I remember we already learned quite a bit about representations. And then somehow we concentrated on this adjoint representation, because the adjoint representation gave rise to root systems. And we use these for the classification. But let's talk in a more general setting about representations of semi-simple Lie algebras. And the important definition here is the character. So remember, the trick is always the same. We start with a representation of G, and we fix a Cartan subalgebra H, and then we restrict the representation we got to H. Then we do the weight space decomposition, and we want to well, an interesting object is an interesting question: what are the dimensions of the individual weight spaces? And we capture these in the following generating function. So we pick any finite dimensional G module. And to this, we associate the character, so-called character of V. What's that? Abbreviated character V. This is the sum for all lambda in P. Ah. P, not R. So recall P is the weight lattice. So this is a subset of all of the dual of the Cartan algebra. These are the linear forms which actually arise as weights of a representation with a non-zero weight space. So we want to form the generating function. So take the dimension of phi lambda. So phi lambda is the weight space of vectors of weight lambda in V. This is some vector subspace, so it has some dimension. Times e to the lambda. Yeah, that's the definition. but what is it? That's the more interesting question here. So what does this weird e to the lambda mean? So there are two interpretations of this, depending on whom you ask. So everybody agrees that this formula defines the character of V. But what is this? the first answer you'll get is this is just a formal object. So a character of V is an element in the group algebra of the weight lattice. That means, what is that? C in bracket P is just the vector space with basis e to the lambda, or lambda is in P. Huh? So we just consider e to the lambda as a formal symbol. Somehow we forget that there is this e inside and this lambda. This is just some basis element. So I mean the natural notation would be b index lambda, but for some reason people call this e upper index lambda. So, but basically here, lambda is just an index to this symbol e and nothing more. So now we've got an infinite dimensional vector space, yeah, because P is a lattice. So we have the elements of the vector space are formal linear combinations of E lambda with some coefficients, such as here. Yeah, we have some linear combinations of these basis elements with some coefficients. So, and I say the group algebra, so there is a multiplication also. And the multiplication is given by the rule, whenever I take two basis vectors, say E lambda times E mu, this should just be E lambda plus mu. So this is somehow why people don't use this lower index notation here, but the upper index notation, just because this rule is somehow what you're used to, right? So now you know how to multiply basis vectors and then linear combinations. You just multiply by the distributive law, and then this gives an algebra of formal combinations, and everything makes perfect sense. So, and the character is just an element of this group algebra, and just some weird way to write down all the dimensions of the weight spaces simultaneously. But there is another possible interpretation, namely the character of V is a function, say, on H, on the Cartan algebra, with values in the set of complex numbers. So how do we interpret such a thing as a function? So if H is an element of the Cartan algebra, I have to say, what does it mean to evaluate the function in this element H? And this is just e to the lambda of H by definition, right? So lambda is a linear form, H is an element of the Cartan, so this is some complex number, so this is the honest exponential function here. So this is now really, maybe I write it again like this, exp lambda of h, right? So this is really the exponential function. So, and by this definition, you can interpret formal characters as a as functions. So, and I won't prove this, but it's equivalent.
Is it some sort of special element aside from this? Or no? Does it mean anything aside from that? Does it have any sort of other meaning?
I'm not sure whether I understand the question.
On the entire Gapos of algebra H. So for
by our second interpretation.
Yeah.
So I'm wondering about our first interpretation, which is saying it's some sort of element. That we don't care. I guess an element doesn't have any meaning within that group algebra.
No, it's just, well,
it's just a particular element in the group algebra.
Yeah. This is just like it's a generating function. So it's if you study, well, it's a general trick that people use in combinatorics and everywhere in stochastics also. So if you have a sequence i from say 0, 1, 2, then you can associate the generating function sum for I from 0 to infinity ai x to the I. So this is how people would do this usually. Mm-hmm. And now you have the exact same two possibilities. Say, well, let's say it's a finite sequence. So almost all ai are 0. Let's suppose this to make the analogy perfect, right? Then this sum, I wrote it as an infinite sum, but it will be actually be a finite sum, so it will be a polynomial. Mm-hmm. And then there are these two interpretations. You can just say, well, what is a polynomial? It really, either it's, you can say x is a formal variable. Right, so then this is just a formal thing. Or, you can say this is a function on C, right? Because you can replace, you can evaluate the polynomial at complex numbers. So, and a priori, this element doesn't have any special role either as a function or as a formal linear combination of, as well as an element of the group algebras. It's just, it's the generating function of our weights. So now we want to study this further and find out which special properties does it have, because this allows us to gather information about our about our representation. Yeah, let me get the small example. Well, the really smallest possible example. So our group is SL2C. Then we defined long ago these irreducible representations VD. So let D be any integer, natural integer. And then we have this homogeneous polynomials of degree D on which SL2 acts. So what's the character of this module? Now remember the basis, there is a basis of VD consisting of monomials of degree D. So there are D plus one of these monomials. And the weights, let me write it down. The weights are D omega, D minus 2, omega, and so on, up to minus D omega. This was an exercise. And all dimensions of these D minus 2k omega are one, right? These, because these weight spaces are just the one-dimensional vector spaces generated by one of the monomials. So in this case, it's easy to write down the character. Well, e to the d omega plus e to the d minus 2 omega plus and so on, plus e to the minus d omega. And so one can write this down as a rational function, e to the d omega minus e to the minus d minus 2 omega divided by 1 minus e to the minus 2 omega. So let's think about this for a while, because this is a bit confusing. So if we take this interpretation of the character as an element of the group algebra, then somehow this doesn't make sense, because this is not an element of the group algebra. No? This is, it is, but it's somehow, it's an, ah. I just wrote it wrong.
Well, we don't look at that as something in the algebra.
Hmm?
That certainly reduces to the thing on top.
Right, right. So exactly. So okay. So this is the interpretation. Just it. Right. So it turns out that I don't know. So anyway, you can watch it formally as an element of the quotient field of this algebra, which is some formal procedure in algebra, how you can produce a field from such a ring, and then this. Well, so basically, what I'm saying is somehow you have to give a sense to this expression, but or if you view it as functions on H, then there seem to be this singularity. So maybe you would want to say this is a meromorphic function on H, but then it turns out that these are, how do you say, non-essential singularities. And so anyway, if you think really hard about it, maybe you have some issues with writing this quotient down. But from a more naive point of view, this is just the geometric series formula. So how do we prove this? Let's forget about the numerator and let's just have a look at the one. It's also times up. So there are more people there. So maybe if you want, you can think about the proof until Tuesday, or I'll continue the proof of this formula on Tuesday.
Geometric series,
exactly. Yeah. That's what I'm doing.